Welcome to the Lumbridge Knight Restless Ghost Quest Guide for Old School RuneScape. This quest can be done by characters at any level. You do need to watch out for a level 13 skeleton, but he can be quite easily avoided. Overall, this is quite an easy quest for a simple quest point, some prayer experience, and the Ghost Speaker amulet. But bring your teleport and energy potions, because there is a fair bit of walking. Welcome to the Lumbridge Knight. Remember to subscribe and like our videos if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks, and guides that we're going to be bringing you on this channel. So without further ado, let the questing begin. Okay, so looking at the quest log, you can start the quest by speaking to Father Aereck, I believe that's how you pronounce his name, I've got no idea, in the church in Lumbridge. This is literally just a few steps east of Lumbridge Courtyard, as you can see on the map. That's where I'm stood just outside of. I'm going to click on the door and go in. There he is, Father Aereck, or however you pronounce his name, it's a strange name. We talk to this guy, and we literally just request a quest. It's that simple. He's going to tell us that in the cemetery, just behind the church there, that's to the south, you can see behind the window, that a ghost is restless, hence the name of the quest, and that he would like it to be settled. So he'd like to stop the ghost haunting his graveyard. And being the kindly adventurers that we are, we're going to agree to do that. So I'm going to click on, and you can see on the map here, there's two houses in the swamp area. So Father Aereck will ask us to go seek out Father Ernie, who is currently on some kind of religious sabbatical in the Lumbridge Swamp. I mean, why not? As you can see by the map there that I'm just pointing out now, there are two buildings in the swamp. You want the most westerly one. And now I'm going to speed the video up. I'm going to make my way over there. Watch out, you can see by the equipment I showed at the start of the video that I'm a low level character. I've done a little bit of training. I think I'm level 5 in all combat abilities at the moment, but these rats are, I think they're level 6, and they are aggressive if you are low level like me, so they might actually go for me, so you've got to kind of avoid them. They're one tried to get me there. They're not like ridiculously hard, they're not hard to kill, but just if you are fresh out of tutorial land, watch out. So here I am, I've arrived at the shack, and here's Father Ernie. Now speak to him. He complains about meditating. You tell him that Father Aereck has got a problem that he can't solve. He's quite unflattering about his friend, and basically gives you the Ghost Speaker amulet, which is a very useful amulet that is needed for several other quests, which I will put in the description just for your reference in case you're wondering. And you can go speak to the ghost now. Now, one thing to mention is, I suppose mainly for like Ultimate Ironman accounts potentially, or just in general, if you lose or destroy the amulet, you can always return here to Father Ernie and get a new one. So you can always get one. You can't only have one, but if you lose or destroy the one you've got, you can always go back and get another one off him. So that's why I mentioned Ironman Ultimate, because obviously, limited bank. It's useful if you can just get rid of it at the end of the quest, so you can do that. Now I'm going to hightail it back to the graveyard, where we're going to now speak to the ghost. If you didn't realise it when I walked past, the ghost is in the crypt. So there's only really one crypt in the graveyard. That's the building. So head through the door, speak to the ghost, and let's see what he wants. So you can activate it by just clicking on the coffin. All you have to do is make sure the Ghost Speaker amulet is equipped before you do that. So make sure you click on that. Then just click on the coffin. The ghost will come out. Says it's weird to actually hear a human that can understand him. Yada, yada, yada. Just say, yep, I understand you, no problem. How can I help you? If you say anything else, it'll just end the conversation. So you're kind of asking him now, is there anything we can do to put his spirit at rest? And he is telling you that his skull has been taken by someone in Wizard's Tower. Okay, so now I'm just going to show you on the map quickly, because I missed it out, the location of the Wizard's Tower. It's very close to Lumbridge, it's not very hard to find. And you can also see that the Imp Catcher quest starts there, so if you haven't started that, please check out my Imp Catcher quest guide. That's another one you can do quite easily. Head out of the crypt once you've got through the dialogue. Now it's probably a good time to mention that if you've got an Amulet of Glory, I believe, you can teleport over there, or any means of teleporting to either Draenor Village or Wizard's Tower, now is a good time to do it, because we need to head over there. So I'm going to walk the long way via the paths, I actually suggest that instead of going north the way I'm going now along the path, you actually go back to the swamp and just walk, or from the back of Lumbridge Castle, just walk a straight line. So walk directly west now. Walk directly west from there and you will arrive at Wizard's Tower. I've gone the sort of roadway, the long way, which is, I have no idea why I did this during the video. I think I was just sort of finding my feet again in old school RuneScape at this point. So I just stuck to the main paths. So this is the main path. It'll take you through the farmland, through Draenor Village, and then head south to Wizard's Tower. You can see Draenor Manor just on the right there, and now I'm heading through Draenor Village and straight down to Wizard's Tower. If you're low level, like, watch out. There's that dodgy jailer again. So you need to peg it past him. Another reason to head west from Lumbridge directly, because you kind of avoid the jailers. Once you get to Wizard's Tower, head inside, and instead of heading up the staircase, go into the same room, but go down the ladder into the basement. While you're in there, you will see Cedrador. He's the wizard in the room on his own there with a double bed, not the one in the corridor. That's for the Room Mysteries quest. I've done a guide for that. So watch out for that quest guide and give it a click. It's popping up on the screen right now if you haven't done that quest. It's another easy one. Now, click on the altar. And as soon as you click on the altar, the skeleton will animate and start attacking you. It's a level 13. So, I mean, you can see me. I put my extra strength on. And I tried to go toe-to-toe with him. You can see he's like kind of like a dodgy green color there. But that should be enough that I'd be able to beat him. And I've got a little bit of food. So I was feeling brave at this point. So I went for it. I've sped this up because it is a rather long battle, rather longer than, embarrassingly long I'd say almost. The weird thing is, when he gets to a certain health as well, he just disappears, so I don't know if that happened for any of you, but if it did, leave a comment, or if anyone killed him, please let me know what he drops. I can't imagine he drops much, but if you watch in a second, he literally just vanishes. So I've got no idea if he actually drops anything, or if maybe that's because he's a cursed skeleton, he's meant to just disappear when you kill it, but there you go, see, look. Boom, vanished. So you either have to survive him for so long, or you can just run away. I advise, to be honest, because in subsequent characters, I just clicked on the altar and then immediately clicked run on. Clicked run on first, clicked on the altar, and as soon as I got the skull in my inventory, I just bailed straight out of there. Straight past Cedrador, who, as I mentioned earlier, Cedrador is for the Rune Mysteries quest, which I've got a quest guide out. So check that one out after this quest if you are looking to get those easy free-to-play quest points. Rune Mysteries is definitely one of them, and it comes in handy, especially if you're going to do magic, so you can craft your own runes. Right, on with the show. So now, for some bizarre reason, I decided to kill a chicken and then spend ages picking up its bones and its carcass and stuff and messing about. Yeah, then I went back to boat to get the bones. I don't know why. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the top of the stairs, and I've saved my Lumbridge teleport for this particular quest, because obviously trekking back to Lumbridge takes a while. So now I recommend you use Lumbridge teleport, which I'm going to do shortly. If you're higher level than me, maybe you can actually do the proper teleport. I will be doing the 3 home teleport, so that will teleport me to Lumbridge after about the 10 second animation plays out, but it's a lot quicker than hightailing it over there. Okay, so boom. Here I am, back at Lumbridge Castle. And now let's go put the skull back into the sarcophagus. So if we head straight into the cemetery again, you don't need to... you'll watch on the animation once I get inside the crypt that I try and click on the skull and then click on the sarcophagus to use it. You don't need to do that. Just literally walk through the door and click immediately on the sarcophagus and it should just work. If it doesn't work, it might be a quirk of RuneLite. RuneLite is the client that I use for RuneScape. It's definitely worth checking out. I'll leave a link in the description. For some reason, I talked to the ghost. Again, you don't need to talk to him. You don't need to use the skull. Just literally open it and click on it. So once you click the correct option, unlike me, you click the coffin first time, you will see a small animation, there we go, where the ghost turns into like this whirlwind and his spirit is free. And he just thanks you for helping him. And congratulations, that is the end of the quest. You just got one quest point, 1125 prayer experience, and a ghost speaker amulet, which is useful for several other quests. All I would say at this point and which is why the video doesn't end immediately, is get back to the bank and bank that amulet for the later quests. So yeah, thanks for watching. If that video was at all useful, please like, subscribe, leave a comment. And this is the Lumbridge Knight saying peace out, guys.